I'll be talking about sourcing from China for private labeling or selling on Amazon. And before I do that, I just want to get to know the audience a bit. May I ask how many of you have never imported from China before? Okay, great. So we've got a pretty experienced crowd here. How many of you have been importing from China for less than a year? Okay, so about 25%. More than a year? Okay, and how many of you had problems dealing with Chinese suppliers? Great, that's my target market right there. I started importing from China about 12 years ago when I was in the UK as a student, and I was bringing in products like fashion jewelry and all kind of stuff. And it was a wholesale e-commerce business. And I did that for about 6 years, made a lot of mistakes and learned some lessons, which I hope to share with you. After that, I decided to move to China because I was really fascinated by whatever was happening in China. It was always in the news. There was a lot to learn, so I came here. For the first year, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I didn't have a business plan as such. Just traveled around, got to know the culture, got to know the people, tried learning the language, and struggled with the chopsticks. So finally, I moved to Guangzhou, and I set up iMix Sourcing. And we, because I had an e-commerce background, so we naturally attracted importers who had an e-commerce background. Amazon wasn't that big yet. I think it's only in the last three or four years, all these Amazon courses coming up. We've had a lot of inquiries, and the last 3 years we've been pretty much focused on Amazon sellers only. And it was just easier for me to connect with them because that's something, I wasn't selling on Amazon. eBay used to be quite big at the time, but I was also selling via my own website. So we started catering to these customers, and that's what I've been doing for over 5 years now. And in that time, we have sourced for over 250 Amazon sellers, sourced more than 600 products across industries, and made some mistakes as well. So I hope I can share some of those mistakes and lessons I learned so you don't have to make those mistakes.